is a lot less effective. So what FDS does is it's a foliar delivery system. So what it does is it temporarily alters the waxy layer that's that every leaf has. It's used to protect the plant from, you know, the elements, bacteria, fungus, those sorts of things. So what it does is it temporarily alters that layer and allows elements to penetrate through to the surface of the leaf. And then what it does, it uses an active push-pull technology. So it's pushing, and as certain elements of the FDS go through, then it actually starts pulling the elements through on the other side. So what you end up with is a product that's specifically designed to take elements you spray on your plants and push them and pull them directly into the leaves of the plants, directly into the chloroplasts and the mitochondria for it to do its stuff.
Because this is outside the realm of my traditional thought in giving the plants what they need, starting with a Uni One, giving everything in a single bottle like that, where now you have a special coating that allows the plant to exert certain elements that then it can take up and release those elements as the plant needs it. But now you're talking about something that can actually push and pull through it. I know chelation and stuff, using Fulvix and Humix, it can break through the layer of skin, of leaf surfaces, of cells in general, help chelation through the root zone. But that's not the same type of action, right?
No. It's a different type of action. We're using an energy transfer action,
Is it much more efficient than those other ones?
It is, and it uses chemical gradients. What it does is, think of it like little conveyor belts. You've got one conveyor belt that's pushing stuff in, and you've got something from the other side grabbing and pulling those things through. So that's what FDS is designed to do. It's designed to take those elements and actively transport them across the plasma membrane of the leaf. So
need to spray underneath the leaf
anymore. No, not at all. And in fact, you know, very little of what you spray on your plants is actually absorbed by the stomata. It's probably less than 1% of anything that you spray on your plant.
Well, that's why I heard a lot of foliar systems or people that say I'm going to spray just raw minerals on my plants. They can have little impact because, for one, like you said, the stomata can't take up very effectively what you're giving to it. But also, by the time it breaks through or has the ability to get through the cells, it's already evaporated. It's no longer available. It's just a dried mineral on the leaf surface.
Yeah, you got a couple of things, you know, working against you there. You've got the waxy layer of the leaf when you're not using something like FDS, so everything just sits on the surface. Stomata are actively transpiring gases. So there's gases coming out of the stomata, which when you think about that, there's a gas or air or gas coming out, it's very hard for things to go in while there's something coming out.
Right.
It kind of doesn't work. So, you know, you got those sort of things acting against you when you're just using, a bottle of water, maybe with a little bit of dish soap to try and get the water to spread a little bit better on the leaf. But it's still just sitting there on the leaf. And then what happens is because of that, and it's not being actively pushed through the plasma membrane, it just sits on the other side of the plasma membrane. When the water evaporates, those mineral elements, or 99.9% of them, are just left sitting there on the leaf, potentially, you know, causing, you know, pH imbalances on the surface of the leaf, blocking light, blocking stomata. So yeah, for anybody that's looking at foliar spraying, they should actually look at using something like FDS, which is a foliar delivery system as opposed to a wetting agent. So wetting agents just wet and spread stuff on the leaf. A delivery agent actively pushes that inside.
Much more than just a surfactant that spreads it across the surface.
Oh, yeah. No. When you notice, too, when you use a product like the FDS, is when you just, say, spray a plant with even just water and just a regular surfactant and see how long it stays on the leaf, then spray some water if you want with something like FDS and watch how fast it's absorbed by the leaf because it's actively being pushed and pulled inside.
So FDS by itself, if you just spray it has no real benefit to the plant. It's made to be used in conjunction with whatever you want to give to the plant.
Yeah, it has
so
to be
whether
used.
It's RNA, whether it's a pesticide, a fungicide, it will work better.
Anything that you want to foliar spray onto your plants, if you want it delivered more effectively, then use FDS. The one caveat that I do say is, particularly if you're using your pesticides or those sorts of things, or anything anyway, is to just, when you're using FDS, only use about 1/4 to 1/3 of the strength of the compound that you want to apply that you would normally use, because FDS is so great at getting stuff inside. If you use your regular amount, you could end up by actually putting too much inside the plant.
And then you frizzle fry it?
Yeah.
All right. Well, the HiQ I want to talk about coming back. Yep. If you want to know more about all these products, ubergrower.com is a website. Let's go back to the phone lines. Oh, Luigi was just about to come up.
Luigi! I look like Luigi with this mustache.
Yeah, there he is. Luigi, you're on the air.
Mario!
What's going on?
What's growing on, brother? Thanks for hanging on so long.
All right. Got a question about setting up my current tent.
Okay.
So I'm at that stage, and I kind of did something a little bit, and my humidity is going from 100 to 33.
100, you're in water?
yeah, you're going to get mold, brother.
Are you in a sealed room? No.
Right. No, he's in his curing tent. He's hanging.
So a tent that I'm trying to, you know, test out. I'm day two of drying now.
Okay, you need to have so much airflow coming from a dry source. You don't want it fluctuating that much. Or a dehumidifier. A 30-pint dehumidifier in a 2x4 or 4x4 tent should be fine. Much bigger than that. You want to get a larger dehumidifier. You need to bypass a little catch and put it on a bucket or a reservoir so it can pump more water so it doesn't shut off. The fluctuation from being too low of humidity, up high, too low. You could get mold, first off, in your drying or your curing. But also, you're going to affect the color of the plant, the flavor of the plant, and also the quality. It's going to become an oxidated and a big problem. You're going to have some hay rather than
it's going to smell
some,
like hay.
Emeralds.
A hay bale.
Yeah, it will. It will. So keep it a nice.
I got that problem.
Well, keep
four more plants that still got to come down.
Okay.
So.
Well, keep it in a nice
get a nice
rigid environment. You don't want it too low either. You don't want it to 50%. Go too fast. Yeah, 35 to 50% I found is fine, but I like to keep it closer to 50% as well, Horty.
Yeah, because you don't want to dry it out too quick either. So I see people like living in like the high desert where there's like really low humidity, and they're like, oh yeah, my shit dries out in like 4 or 5 days, and I'm like, I can tell.
4 or 5 hours.
Yeah, that's smart.
You don't want that. And listen to what I'm trying to tell you. It's so imperative that you get the dehumidifier like yesterday that, like, don't put gas in your car. Don't take your bitch out for dinner. Go buy a dehumidifier because the amount, the quality level that you're going to maintain by purchasing a dehumidifier will more than get itself back off the final product. It will pay for itself if you cure your stuff properly.
I've seen it time and time again where people put all their blood, sweat, and tears into the grow and half-ass their dry, and it fucks up. And they come to me and say, T, I mean, I'm ditching this strain just because it doesn't smell right, man. It's like everyone else is just saying it smells like hay. Well, hey, it's because it's you.
It's you.
It's the gardener.
Everything you grow is going to smell like hay.
I'm really good at that.
Yeah, I know you are.
Got a horse?
Yeah. I got horses going. Hey,
hey, Duffy's talking.
Oh, sorry.
Go ahead.
All right. In the tent, just in the basement, just a circulating fan with an exchange every couple minutes. It's at 33 to 35% humidity at about, you know, 70 degrees.
That's fine if you can keep it there.
Yeah, if you can keep it
if
there.
If it shoots up to 60% or...
That's not going to dry it out too fast. That's what I was under the assumption, that I'm drying out too fast.
Well, I prefer 50% humidity, but 35 to 45% is a lot better than 65 to 70%.
And also, you want to keep some wind on the plants. You want those things swaying as they're hanging there.
Yeah.
You don't want to blow them over with a fan to where they're like riding on the riding on the wind.
You want them to still be vertical, not horizontal.
Yeah, but you want them kind of moving in the wind, just like you wanted your plants moving in the wind when you were growing them. Like a light breeze from an oscillating fan, just keeping them shaking a little bit.
Hey, listen, Luigi, I'm going to make...
I originally had that going, and I added the humidifier to increase the humidity and...
No. Dude, the worst thing that you can do is let most of it dry out and then rehydrate it. This is a problem that people do when they do a perpetual harvest too. That if their stuff at one point when they pull it down isn't ready to be taken out of the dry room, and they put a bunch of more wet things in there, and it rehydrates the rest of them, it ruins the color. It'll turn brown.
Okay.
It'll ruin the flavors too. No, Luigi, I'm gonna make things easier on you, dude. I'm gonna send you some of the Uni One from our boys at Uber. You know, you're focusing on a lot of things, but getting it right in the grow and bloom. Uni One has it down to make it as easy as possible. You heard Steve tonight. I'm sure you were on hold for a while. Make sure you go to Uber Grower to learn more about it. And then I'm also going to send you some Terpinator from our friends at Terpinator over at Left Coast Wholesale for you to try out to help bring out the full genetic expression of your plants, okay?
Awesome, brother. Appreciate
Thanks,
it.
Luigi. You stay safe, John. All right, keep on moving on. Hi, Q. Steve. Hi, Q, brah.
Okay,
it's the aloha for the plants, bro.
It is, bro. It's my most favorite product.
We talked about it right then with Luigi, curing. What happens if you go through the whole grow and you get to the end and you can't preserve your harvest? Well, that's a problem. But if you get through your curing and you were bountiful, you use the Uni One, the Pyro K, all that good stuff to get the most out of it, and maybe you got a little bit more than you're used to. What do you do while it's sitting around and getting old and losing some of its vigor, or you know what I mean, losing some of its punch? You got the Hi-Q to save it.
Yeah, well, you got the Hi-Q that saves it. How it does that is that you spray that on the last 3 days of flowering before you harvest.
Yeah.
And what it does is it infuses the essential oils in the leaves of your plant with a special fat-soluble form of vitamin C that then acts as the prime antioxidant all the way through your harvesting, your drying, your curing, and it stops the active fractions in your essential oils that give you the punch. It stops those from degrading into inactive fractions. So you get, you know, you preserve that quality, and particularly too, if you've got to sit on some stuff, you know, you grew a little bit too much, you got to sit on a little bit more than you normally do, then Hi-Q keeps that quality there. And for most intents and purposes, people don't realize the amount of quality that they lose. Even the best grower with the best setup for curing their plants are still subjecting those essential oils to a huge oxidative stress.
Yep.
And Hi-Q stops all that. So for most people, you actually don't even perceive it as preserving the quality of your plants. You'll actually perceive it as increasing the quality of your plants, because for the first time you've actually experienced your plant how it really wants to be, not the way you've experienced after the oxidization's decreased the quality.
Well, let me give the listeners an example. You harvest, you have your personal jar of consumables that may be a decent size. Those first consumables off the top, although by the time you get to the bottom, they're much different. First off, you have the light that is in your house around if it's a clear jar. You have opening and closing it where the oxygen and stuff is coming in and actually oxidating and destroying the molecules. If you had left any moisture in it, that becomes a problem because that speeds it all up and can lead to a quicker decomposition that has certain gases that can cause even further oxidation effect. With the Hi-Q, it seals all that up and makes it last longer. So off the top piece of the jar to the bottom piece is AAA.
Exactly. You shouldn't notice a difference in quality.
That's awesome.
I also use the Meh Farm Jar with the Muron glass, the little blue one that they have.
Oh, so you don't
now.
Get the light.
So you don't get the light. That's awesome.
They gave me one of those, and it actually is pretty legit. I had even like the little red and green, like blue pop top little dispensary type containers that you get from the store. In my smoking room, the light shines in, and I noticed that some stuff in a jar that I hadn't touched in a while started to like turn goldish yellow from sitting in a regular jar. But the Muron glass stuff keeps all that light out of there. It's pretty gnarly.
That's cool.
That's crazy.
Combine
dude.
That with the Hi-Q and you're exactly. Fucking legend, mate.
Wow.
The only legend here is Steve. And of course, Ted. That's what I said. You haven't said much.
Oh, no, I'm listening as well.
Are you just there being like, yeah, this is the look you have when you have the sweetest beard in the room?
Yeah.
I used to have that feeling a lot.
Yeah,
now
I
shaved,
now
and now you see four of my chins. I didn't even know I had grown a fourth chin until I shaved. It's been like a year.
You went from, like, the bearded guy to the Amber Alert guy to now the teddy bear guy.
Yeah, if I need to disappear, I've got several different looks.
Yeah. T, can I ask you, since we're conversing, one thing on the FDS.
This is a talk
since
show.
Since we're conversing.
That, yeah, maybe Steve can elaborate. One of the things about the FDS that I think people don't tap into is the way you can use like Azomax or Azotrol or something real mellow and put it in the leaf for the suckling insects, instead of using something super wicked.
So it makes it systemic immediately.
Right. So I think it's a big deal for people. Like, I mean, some people that are finally tapped into that, it's a hard point to get across when they get it. And so he was tapping in on the science, so I thought maybe we revisit that.
Because when you're dealing with like things like mites or thrips, sucking insects, so they're sucking the juice out of the plant. when you spray them, yeah, you get some contact effect, but those most of those pesticides or insecticides, they're designed for the insect to ingest it to do its job.
Right.
So just having it sitting on the surface of the leaf or the insect is not really letting it do its job, whereas something like FDS will push it inside the plant, and so that, you know, when those little guys, you know, have their next little feed, you know, they're getting full of insecticide the way that it was intended, and then you'll actually have much better control, and then a lot less of this thing now where, you know, where you only do a half a job, that those insects then start gaining immunity. They build up genetic immunity to those things. You've got to start going for like harder things.
Yeah.
This allows you to use softer stuff like, you know, the Azomax or the Azotrol or Pyrethrum. Which is another really, really good gentle one.
What about Avid?
Avid. I use Avid, Fluoramide, and Paclobutrol.
Lutrazol? Yeah.
I've never seen any bugs.
All at the same damn time.
In his protein shake.
The day of, right? Yeah.
Along with my Azel Gold powder I'm putting in my protein shake.
You never see a bug.
Well, that's a good point because, listen, if you're spraying your plants trying to get rid of mites or bugs or using foggers, and it may knock them down. It may kill the ones that you can see or limit the population. But if you didn't get every single one and every single egg, you still have mites. They're going to come back. So you need to get something in the plant. You make the plant its own preventative measure.
Exactly.
I really like that idea, and I think that more people should be doing that, in fact.
And bugs are less likely to attack healthy plants. They usually go for the weaker plants.
Correct.
First.
Always.
Is that why Dove keeps getting cancer?
Yep.
Yes.
I keep fighting it off.
Just kidding. Keep fighting off. Oh, I didn't tell you. His wife's name is Cancer.
And she was born in the sign of Cancer.
Oh, no. Her name is Syphilis.
Again, true. I don't have any of that.
Tim from Arizona.
Oh, shit.
What's going on?
So, Tim.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey, man. You've been hanging out a while. Let's get to your question.
First, I got like a good tip. I was wondering if you brought by you guys. I got really bad water, so my humidifier, I started saving my old water and putting that in the humidifier instead.
What the hell did you say?
Well, could you repeat that? We got like a bad... Hey, could you go like on top of the house and get a little better cell signal and repeat your question?
Horty, I think he said he put fire in his water and...
Oh, I thought he said he put old dirty water in his humidifier.
I thought he said he did fire in it.
No, instead of dirty... My water's so bad out of the tap.
Okay, so it's like hard water.
50 parts per million.
Right.
So hard. I need my old water for my when I change my reservoir, and I put that in the humidifier instead.
I wouldn't put it with your nutrients in there, brother. You're going to be humidifying.
Yeah, that's even harder water than what you have out of the tap.
Yeah,
and then all those salts are going to dry out in the humidifier.
And rust your hoods.
And screw everything
ruin
up.
Ruin your electrical connections, any electronics you have in there.
Well, that's hardcore, bro. I didn't even think
Take
of that.
Take your water from your old res and pour it on your plants out in your yard so that you have like the nicest yard in the neighborhood.
He's in Arizona. Yeah. They don't have plants.
Oh, that's right.
He's got a rock
cacti.
Garden.
Pour it on that one rock.
Yeah, the rock loves it.
All right, for my question, though, is the defoliation this time where you pull off most of the unleaves.
Yep.
The deforestation.
I'm into four and a half weeks of them. They look good, but they just look a little fruity.
They look fruity?
They just seem like they're overwatered.
They look a little droopy.
Well, remember, when you pull off all those leaves, the plant can't transpire the water from the root zone that it normally does out of the leaves, so it's probably you're stripping it off, and it doesn't have any method to get that water out of the plant. Selectively removing fan leaves is a good idea, especially if they're covering up budding sites directly below them, like a little shed over the top of a developing flower below it. But stripping down all the fan leaves off your plant it doesn't have any solar panels to do its thing. So
pruning,
that's not really advised.
Pruning is an excellent technique to get the most out of your plant, but there is a
There's a balance. Yeah.
If you do it too much, you're going to stress the shit out of the plant, and the plant will stop taking up what it needs, and then it can't transpire, just like Cordy was talking about. So,
and it also can't photosynthesize because you've removed all the solar panels, basically.
Never more than 50% of the leaves. You have to be selective. The older ones that are showing chlorosis are going to be the first ones to go. Then it goes down to the ones covering up prime flowering sites are the next ones to go. Think of this. The plants mostly grow symmetrical. If on the main stalk there's one leaf to the left, there's one that really close by to the right, okay? So if you take off one big leaf that's on the left, leave the one on the right and stagger it as you go down so you get better light penetration, but you still have your solar panels, you still allow the plant to transpire.
Mm. Word.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
Sugars.
But be careful of taking them all off. You don't want to necessarily do that.
And make sure you let them dry out before you water them again, because when they're overwatered, if you just keep watering them, you're not helping the problem.
Yeah, I'm sure you can see
You have to let them dry out some so you get more oxygen into that root zone, and those roots can stretch back out trying to find water, and then you water them.
Just go knuckle deep in your grow medium.
Knuckle deep in the medium from the top. If it's cool and wet, don't water it. If it's dry and warmer, water it.
Duff goes knuckle deep all the time.
I always do, man.
That's first knuckle, that's goes. As far as he
but
can
my
get.
Plants are always brown,
and that's when he's laying on his back and she's straddling him.
My plants that's are still brown.
Got his pelvic thrusting.
Oh, I thought he was self-knuckling. I didn't think there was a shame.
I think you guys are lying about green plants.
Hey, but, you know, Tim, it is all a learning process. No one knows everything about growing, and you know, you're learning a hard lesson right now. So take that knowledge that you're gaining and put it to good use. Use it as a learning experience. If more leaves start growing back and you can regenerate, just be real careful about stripping those off, okay?
Say thank you, Jesus. Forgive me those beautiful leaves.
What about someone laid in a flower, Steve, if they use the RNA and FDS late? Will it help regenerate those leaves?
Late in flower, not so much. RNA is, you know, you really need to be using it in veg.
Okay. Okay, well, let's send him some RNA and FDS down to Arizona. So hopefully, if this was not so sweet, he can spray it on his veg plants and cut some time off.
I believe
I'm
going
to send
that
out to you. I'm also going to send you some Armor SI from GH. Our buddies at GH came up with a silica product to help bolster your plants against drought, against heat, against other stresses, as well as making it tougher or easier for the plant to resist molds and mildews and bugs. Itself. It's also a systemic preventative that I like to use in the plant.
You need to grow with Jesus, Tim, with Dr. Duff.
Tim, where do you shop at?
Tim? FC Green, Tempe, Arizona.
Nice, dude. Those guys are really cool.
Yeah.
The RNA, shout the FDS, and I'm going to throw in some smart pots because you shop at CA Green. Thanks, Tim.
Right, you just got
hooked the fuck up.
Yeah. Stay safe.
I think he was shot.
Word.
I think he had a bad connection. I think our phone lines, there was a little bit of rain here, and we're on a plain old telephone system.
We're surrounded by Solistex ballast.
Oh, maybe. Yeah. There ain't no Solistex ballast around here. I'll tell you that
Solistex
much.
Solistex went around and did, like, they turned them on around us in our cars.
Oh, man. All right, let's go to the phones. Guy, you're going to get me in trouble. Guy from Santa Fe Springs.
Hey, what's good, guys?
Not much, dude. Man. What's growing on?
I have a question about grow lighting. I have two grow light setups. I have a cheap HPS, and I have a pretty cool metal halide.
What makes the metal halide pretty cool and the HPS cheap? Can you tell us, like, what brand it is, what size wattage it is, and what type of reflector?
The HPS is some cheap hood I bought at a yard sale, to be honest.
All right. Very you got a ball on a budget somewhat.
It's an extra sun.
Extra suns are decent reflectors.
Yeah, well, I have a grow light that I just got. OG grow light.
No, that's a better one.
Yeah, and I didn't really want to use this extra sun anymore. I wanted to just honestly get rid of it. I was wondering if I would be able
I'm
to
not
get
looking
the
to buy it.
From it and use it on my OG grow light.
Oh, yeah, you can use the bulb. It's the bulbs are compatible with any hood.
Yeah, but let me ask you a question. How old is the bulb?
I'm not really too sure because I haven't used it.
Right. See, that's the problem. There's a couple problems we get into with Craigslist and yard sale buys is or used equipment in general. First and foremost, the bulb, after about 6 months of use, is going to drastically start to reduce in its ability to produce the light intensity that it did when it was brand new. And I've seen people's yields cut by more than half because they're using old, outdated bulbs. The second thing you run into is the actual reflective surface inside of reflectors also goes bad over time. So if that extra sun is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 years old, it may not be reflecting the light as well as a brand new hood or a brand new insert in it would actually do. What size ballast are you using with this OG hood?
On the OG hood, it's a 600. Oh, the ballast is actually 1,000 watt, but it's dimmable. But
is it a select-a-watt? Because you don't want to just dim it and stick a 600-watt bulb in there.
What do you mean?
There's two types of digital ballast. There's ones that are selectable wattage, like, for instance, 1,000-watt, 600-watt, 400-watt. Yeah, and then there's ballasts that go 100%, 75%, 50%.
No, it's 1,000-watt. Like it dims down to 600
or a 400. Okay, yeah. If you're going to run a 600 in that, just go buy a new bulb. It's going to more than pay for itself. You'll probably get double the yield out of it if the bulb that you're using is old. And then also, what if the bulb you're using is so old that it's near its life end, and then you get 2 or 3 weeks into bloom, and then the bulb just burns out and doesn't work, and you have to go buy a new one anyways. So I'd start with a fresh bulb if I were you in that OG hood.
Yeah, it's gonna, your eyes not gonna pick up on it.
Right,
not
your
gonna,
eyes won't know.
Your plants will. You'll be like, man, this is a cheap ass fucking hood. Be like, yeah, because you've got a 1987 bulb in there.
Yeah, get a new bulb. They're not that expensive.
Yeah, actually, let's send him 1,000-watt real red.
Well, he
high
said
pressure
he wants
soda.
To run 600.
But he's got 1,000-watt ballast.
But he says it does select a watt, and he plans on running. Would you prefer to run 1,000-watt or 600-watt?
I'd honestly, because
OG will tell you a 600-watt bulb in their OG hood will perform as well as 1,000-watt.
That's true.
So I'm thinking of him having heat issues, things of that. So you specifically were going to run it at 600 because you already have a 600-watt bulb?
Well, I was going to run it at 600 because I have a 4x4 grow tent, and I only have one inline fan.
That's a good take. 600-watt
real 600-watt, there you go.
I'm also going to send you some green pads for your CO2, your environment up in there. The green pads CO2, rain CO2 down. Give them a little squirt, squirt.
Squirt.
Get that CO2 level up. That will increase the amount of light the plant can take in, too. Photosynthesis requires light, water, and CO2. You increase the amount of light. You're going to need an increasing amount of CO2 to get the most out of your plants, and then correlate the nutrient as well. Check out the Uber nutrients next time you're at your local hydro store, too. The Uni One, the FDS, the RNA, the Pyro K, the Hi-Q, they're all super high quality, super easy to use. If you're looking for a fail safe to be successful, ubergrower.com is where you want to be, okay?
Right on, brother.
All right, you stay safe, bro.
Okay. Didn't even ask him where he shopped.
Oh, sorry. I've been fucking that up this tonight. I've only got two written down.
And then you'd be like, we don't even know where the guy is.
Well, the screener's getting this shit. Oh, he hung up. I guess we don't know where he is.
Oh, well.
He's got his number.
He said he's in Santa Fe Springs.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he'll probably be coming to Cerritos.
Probably. Oh, February 28th, we'll be at Cerritos. You guys coming to the Cerritos Customer Appreciation Day, February 28th? Just set in stone. You coming? You going to be talking to Uber down there?
Yeah.
All right. So all the listeners can come and meet Stead in person. Is Steve going to be here too?
More than likely.
Maybe. Steve's like, are there going to be more alcohol and unspeakables?
Aloha and fellowship? He's in.
Yeah. Well, more safety meetings.
Yes, that's right.
Oh, it's almost time for that grand prize question.
Well, we've got Ray from Ray calling in. Last caller of the night before the grand prize question. Ray from Ray.
Hello?
What's up, bro?
Ray?
Hold on. This is a good scene. Oh, yes.
What's up, Ray?
Hello? She loved it.
Ray, wake up, bro. You're on the Heavy Tea Grow Show, bro. Aloha.
Mahalo.
What's your
question?
Go ahead. I got an answer.
Grow lights and whatnot.
You recently bought what?
Grow lights and whatnot.
I said a grow
light. All right. Obviously, you didn't buy the new iPhone. Come on, Ray. It's been a while.
Come on, Ray. Come on. We'll get your question out. We can help you out, dude.
All right. The plants are growing. It's like
They started growing, and they maybe reached four feet, and they just stopped. And now the leaves are browning off. I'm just trying to see what is it that I need to do.
Well, I bet I can knock this one out of the park.
Bugs.
We won't even get into the reason why the fuck you would grow a 4 foot tall plant indoors, because you know it's near the end of the night. But how big of a container is it?
Before you say why not, we don't want to grow that big a plant indoors, Ray. We want them to be about 2.5 feet by the time we flip them.
So that they finish under 4 feet. But anyways, what size container are your plants in?
They're in like 5 gallon bucket size.
And are you doing soil?
Soil, yes.
Soil, and it's plastic containers?
Yes.
And have you been feeding them nutrients, or did you just stick them in the dirt and let them grow?
I've been given nutrients, but I could say I could probably give them better nutrients than what I am.
What are you giving them?
It's a bloom product that one of my friends had gave me.
Okay. He was gifted some stuff, which you can't hate on.
No. I'm not hating on that. If you're not giving it a complete nutrient, then you're going to have an issue. Yeah, if you're in a 5 gallon bucket and your plant's 4 feet tall, and if it's really bushy, you might be root bound in that container, because that's getting pretty big.
I think he is, for sure.
And when you get root bound, leaves start to die. The plant doesn't grow any further. It just kind of stops growing.
And a plant that tall, you're going to get chlorosis at the bottom because the light can't penetrate.
Yeah, are the brown leaves down at the bottom, or are they at the top of the plant?
It started off at the bottom, but now they're rounding off to the top of it.
Yeah, you're root bound. You need to get that. Go get some smart pots, the patented fabric pot. Get a 7 gallon smart pot and transplant them all. And the fabric pot allows you to have a smaller volume of medium without getting root bound, because it air prunes. It allows the air to breathe through the fabric, and it pushes the roots back. When they're in plastic, they just hit the side of the sidewall of the pot and keep going round and round till they start choking themselves out, where they can't get oxygen, and you're going to start seeing that sickly look. And next thing that's going to happen, our bugs are going to start coming in, because you have a big-ass sick plant there that's giving off all kind of pheromones and stuff, and it's the season where bugs are looking for somewhere else to go rather than the cold weather outside. So they're going to come right in after your sickly plants.
All right. That makes sense. And one more question. Would it be safe to move it outside, being that right now is a good time for flowering?
It's not a good time right now. Where are you at, Australia?
Right now, yeah.
Are you in Australia? Where are you at? Where are you at?
Sounds like an auto flower. Ray.
Where is Ray?
Australia, mate.
Ray, where are you at?
California.
California, you mean that's the same as saying I'm on the East Coast. What part of California? In San Diego, or are you in Northern California where it's 25 degrees outside at night?
Yuba City.
Well, yeah, it's not, outdoors not a good time right now.
It's a little bit cold outside right now for plants.
People will be using greenhouses, high tunnels, these type of things that they put heaters or propane burners in, but not a good time to go outside. What you need to do is transplant them to get them healthy. If you're trying to grow these to be an outside plant eventually and not flower inside, you then need to hack this thing down. You need to take it down about a foot after you transplant. You don't want to do too much at one time. 2 or 3 days later, take it down another foot and keep the plants about 2.5 feet in your 7 gallon smart pots. And you should be good till March, mid-March. You could put them out by the beginning of April, and you'll go in a much bigger pot than the 7 gallon pot. A lot of outdoor guys, if you go the full season, you'll be in a 50, 100, or a 200 gallon smart pot.
And let me ask you one final question. What size and what kind of light are you using for the plants?
1,000 watt bulb.
1,000 watt? Okay. Yeah, you're going to need at least 1,000 watts on a plant that big. So, like Heavy T said, transplant it and then go in and top it off, like kind of cut it back like a hedge. Cut off the top of the plant. Don't remove too much of the plant. Like he said, do it in two steps, and you'll notice that the foliage beneath the top of the plant that's there, it will regenerate, and it'll all grow back, and then it's probably a good time
to flip
it.
And as the new foliage starts to appear that's healthy, all that sickly crap, just rip it off.
Yeah, rip it all off. Once you got fresh, nice, healthy shoots on there, remove all the garbage.
All right.
Come on. Dr. Ray, you can do this, brother. Don't overthink it. Transplant, hedge it down, and then remove all the nonsense.
Oh, shit.
And what would be good nutrients you say I should recommend?
I'm going to send you some of the uni one. I want you to make it as easy as possible.
Yeah. One bottle.
I'm also going to send you some of the crazy swell. So when you go into bloom, the crazy swell will help with those organic, some organic flavors, some organic aromas. That's the newest product from Mission Fertilizer. And I'm going to send you some smart pots. You don't have enough time to wait for the smart pots I'm going to send you and the uni one, though. Okay, so maybe go to your local hydro store, you get a bottle of Uni One and some smart pots, and then you re-up when the stuff arrives from me, okay?
Boom.
All right, Ray, talk to my screener, brother. You're breaking up a little bit, but I do appreciate you calling. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our open phone line session. Now is the time to say thank you very much, Uber. Yes. You guys are the men.
Hey, thanks to you. It was great, man.
Thanks, buddy.
Stead, you are the aloha spirit of the century, man. I can't believe that you aloha. Said but two words. Usually we can't shut you up.
Yeah.
The boss Steve's is here. We know.
There's a lot to learn.
He knows his place.
The big kahuna was here.
That's it.
Hey, Steve, seriously, man, coming all the way down from Canada, I really appreciate you. Let's give him a round of applause.
That's great. Thank you.
Yeah, dropping science right here on Heavy T's Grow Show. Nobody wants to be there.
It's not horrible. It's pretty good.
Yeah,
you just hate it because that's where Max Yield's located.
And because they screw ballast parts to 2x6s.
Hey.
And they use advanced nutrients.
It's so cold it works.
They trim their shit with a hedge trimmer. And they don't cure it very well. And they don't let me into the country because of my previous record. So fuck.
Not that had anything to do with it.
Bastards.
Since my record sucks.
Best things from Canada are Eric Coulomb. Eric Bixa. Canadian Bacon. And Fireball. And everything else. And
what about the Road to America?
Yeah, the Road to America was the number one thing coming out of Canada.
Mark Emery. True. Mark Emery had a lot.
He had kooky genetics
and,
whatever.
And Uber. Our buddies at Uber Nutrients.
Well, Uber's actually from Australia. They just live in Canada now. That way I can like them.
True. Steve's over here been like, really, bro? It's my company. Let me tell you where it's fucking from, pal.
No, I'm just telling myself that. I'm just telling myself
The Uni One, the FDS, the RNA, the Pyro K, the Hi-Q, the Recover, all great products. Check it out. If you don't see it at your local hydro shop, you go educate the owners. You tell them what's up. You demand to have what works the best. And really, Uber is right there at the top echelon of what you could be putting into your plant each and every day, guys. Thank you so much for coming on the show. It was a wealth of knowledge.
Thank you for having us.
We'll see you February 28th at the grand opening, Stan. Hopefully Steve comes down. That will be awesome. But now is the time for the grand prize question. You really have to listen to the entire show, so hopefully you did, because Horty Chris is going to pull some obscure fact that happened in the last 4 hours out of his anus. Here he goes.
Yeah. It's a two-part question.
No, two-part.
Every week's a damn two-part.
Okay, well then it's a one-part because we have...
It's one part with two answers.
One-part anus.
It's a one-part. What event did I attend Sunday night at a strip club in Portland? It has a specific name. What was it?
I don't even remember this.
Yeah, people had to be listening in the first five minutes of the show.
That's right. And if you don't like that one, then what was the new product that Cindy debuted here tonight on the show from Blue Lab?
Okay, what was the new product that Cindy debuted? Bonus.
Or a Horty flip box.
That's a bonus.
We will do.
You give away my shit, dude. That's my shit. Give away your shit. A Black Dog LED. Hand signed by Duff.
We'll all sign it.
It doesn't work, but you could use it as a coffee table or end table.
Okay.
Paperweight.
Hold on. Let me do this real quick, guys. Then we can have more fun outside during the safety meeting. What was the brand new product that Blue Lab debuted right here on tonight's show? And for the super bonus question. What event did Horty Chris attend while he was in Portland that had to do with naked chicks and singing? Figure it out. 562-653-0707. Phone lines are now open.
And you can find the answer on my Instagram because I posted a poster picture
from the event.
So if you go to HORTIKRIS on Instagram and scroll down a couple of pics, you'll see a picture of the actual title of the event that I went to.
Rocky Horror Picture
562-653-0707. We're going to be right back after this safety meeting. DFCRadio.com.
On the floor, shout out, working on the wave with some more, and I love it. chips at my show. Just walked outside and it's sitting on four. And I love it. DFCRadio.com.
It must be Wednesday, because you're listening to Heavy T's Grow Show.
Botanic Air is proud to introduce a revolutionary three-part nutrient system that is the culmination of over 15 years of research and development. The Kind Plant Nutrient System. Designed by leading plant physiologists, this is the most versatile, effective, yet easy-to-use plant nutrient system ever created. It all starts with Kind Base. Kind Base contains nitrogen and calcium, but no trace minerals, magnesium, or sulfur. By placing those nutrients in the Grow and Bloom formulas, you have greater control over how your plants grow in your medium of choice. Using CocoCoir or RO water, just add more base to increase calcium levels. Growing in clay pebbles or rock wool, then just reduce the amount of base to ensure the proper calcium level. It's that easy. Kind Grow contains trace minerals and a proprietary blend of all natural ingredients to help maximize root growth, reduce internodal spacing, and create a lush canopy. Kind Bloom was formulated with the optimum phosphorus to potassium ratio. Your plants will have healthy branch and stalk development, accelerated flower set, and increased yields. Kind Bloom also contains magnesium to help improve photosynthetic efficiency, which is critical in accelerated growth environments. To put it more simply, Botanicare's Kind Nutrient System is the only nutrient system that is fully customizable to your kind of plants and medium. Botanicare Kind Base, Grow, and Bloom. Fully customizable. Any plant, any medium. For more information, go to botanicare.com. Botanicare Kind. Make it your kind.
That was a joke.
And then, hit me up when you're ready. Hit me up when you're ready.
You're like Nachos Bel Grande, 400 calories.
I don't eat Nachos Bel Grande, but I do have a cookbook on how to make numerous under 400 calorie recipes, which hence.
Hi, and welcome to Non-Specific Hydro.
Yeah, hey, I have a buddy of mine that was telling me about a great additive.
Okay, do you remember the name?
Yeah, his name's Steve. He's a good buddy.
No, the product.
No, he told me it was a super concentrated organic enhancer. Comes in a yellow bottle.
Well, it sounds like he's talking about Floralicious Plus from General Hydroponics.
I don't think that was the name, but he also told me it was a vegan bioplant stimulator that contained vitamins, plant sugars, amino acids, seaweed extract.
Yeah, that would be General Hydroponics Floralicious Plus.
I don't think that's it, man. He told me it was something like Dora Vicious Flush or something, and he said it was like an organic supplement that could also be used in vegging or flowering, and that it was compatible with hydro soil and cocoa.
Yes, that would be General Hydroponics Floralicious Plus.
Oh, hey, man. I just remembered what it's called. It's Floralicious Plus.
Oh, good. I was drawing a blank.
Floralicious Plus from General Hydroponics. Ask for it by name.
What's up, everybody? You're listening to the Heavy Tea Grow Show. La, 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 la.
Hey, Dr. Duff, are you signing up for another one of those internet dating sites after your divorce?
Nah, I'm just ordering these freaking douchebags from China here. Just gonna be saving a lot of money on it, about a buck a bag.
Did you say douchebags?
Yeah, they're pots. They're fabric pots. They're, made in China. You know, they save a dollar a bag from all the other.
Oh, it sounds like an imitation smart pot or something.
Yeah, save a dollar, but, you know, I'm pretty sure these douchebags are gonna work.
Dude, I had a buddy of mine who used those same douchebags. He bought them direct from China. It killed his whole garden.
Bro, what? So I'm better off spending that extra dollar on a smart pot?
I'd get a smart pot.
Don't be a Duff man. Make sure to buy the original patented smart pot. Check them out at smartpots.com.
Nobody's safe with Dr. Duff lurking around the fucking expo. Nobody's safe.
Run for your lives! It's the Terminator!
No, it's not the Terminator, it's the Terpinator!
Oh wow, what's that?
Oh, you haven't heard? You have to try this stuff. The Terpinator is the newest creation from Rizoflora Incorporated. It's the one and only product on the market that has proven to increase the concentration of terpenes in your aromatic plant oils and glands.
How does this Terpinator work?
The Terpinator works by utilizing fundamental plant metabolites through a proprietary reaction that catalyzes the increase in terpene production. Its unique composition provides the basic building blocks plants require to produce flavorful oils, and a significant increase in terpenes, which will increase your aromas and flavors.
Nice. I bet with all the increase in terpene content, your plants must just be covered in resins. Oh man, I'm currently using products right now that's designed to increase the resins. Should I swap them out?
Well, that's correct. Terpenator works great alongside other products, but it's the only product out there that is going to give you a higher terpene content. Having a higher terpene content means bigger glands and increasing gland size, which makes a dramatic difference in appearance as well as more pungent odors. Terpenes are not only your aromatic plant oils, but your plant's genetic fingerprint as well. Those terpenes boost your plant's natural defense mechanism against insects and mold.
I really want to try this product. Does it have any harmful chemicals or PGRs?
Heck no. The Terpenator utilizes only organic inputs and produces notably amazing results in a matter of weeks. It is both a soil and hydroponic system friendly fertilizer that is compatible with any nutrient line out there. It is recommended to use this product during your entire flowering cycle, starting from the first week of bloom at 15 milliliters. However, there has been a lot of feedback of people getting amazing results when bumping it up to 30 milliliters per gallon the last 3 weeks of bloom.
Wow, this is the ultimate game changer. Dude, I have to get Terpenator. How do I get this stuff?
To increase dry weight, smell, taste, and a complete overall quality of your flowers, go to www.terpenator.com and make it AAA today.
Oh, hi, Billy. What can I help you with today?
Well, Tina, it's my plants. I've been trying to get them healthier by using foliar sprays, and I'm just not getting the improvements I was hoping.
I understand. Did you hear that?
Yeah, and it's getting louder.
It's Optic Foliar Guy.
That's right.
Crap, look what he did to my ceiling.
Have you heard of my Optic Foliar line of ready-to-use foliar sprays?
Gosh, I guess not.
Well, I guess it's about time you did. Start with Optic Foliar's Transport. It's a revolutionary delivery agent that helps get the ingredients in your sprays directly into the plant through the leaf surface. Unlike other sprays, it can be used with the lights on and without adjusting the pH.
Wow, that sounds amazing.
It sure is, Billy. Using Optic Foliar's watts, you can help your plants use the energy provided by sunlight or HID lights, leading to an exponential increase in growth, which produces bigger yields. And what's the easiest way to provide additional nutrition for plants using watts? Optic Foliar's Rev. REV provides additional nutrients needed to maintain higher growth rates, resulting in greener, healthier plants.
Gee willikers, do you have anything to help correct deficiencies?
The new Optic Foliar Overgrow not only corrects deficiencies, but also provides increased performance. Overgrow prevents and combats problems that attack your leaves, ensuring you always get a healthy harvest.
Jiminy, it sounds like you have the solution to all my foliar needs.
That's right, Billy. When you use Transport with Watts, Rev, and Overgrow, you can expect improved health and increased yields. Better yields are only a spray away.
Thanks, Optic Foliar Guy.
Well, I'm off. There are more plants that need my help.
No, wait! Hey, man, the door works, you know.
Optic Foliar. Transport, Rev, Watts, and now Overgrow. The complete foliar system that will dramatically improve your plant's health and harvest. For more information, go online to opticfoliar.com.
The next level of growing is here.
The growing revolution is here.
DFCRadio.com.
DFCRadio.com.
And I can vouch for Green Pass. Green Pass definitely works.
That's Horty's Pimpin' 101.
Hey, Heavy Maze here, down at the local hydro shop, talking with local growers on how to improve their garden.
What's up?
Now, I've noticed you have a bottle in your hand. What is in that bottle?
This bottle's a PGR. I use it for height control because I'm in a tent.
You're using PGRs to control the height of your plants, but haven't you noticed that the quality of your plants goes down tremendously?
Oh, God, that's the worst part about it, you know, and I go to the farmer's market a lot, and I try to give them my fresh fruits and stuff, and they beat me down on the prices ever since I've used it.
Well, what if I told you right now there's a product today you can buy that brings back all of the lost essential oil production and quality, it recovers the natural look and flavor of your plants, and maintains flower size, but gets rid of excessive flower hardness.
What, dude? Now, slow down. You're telling me there's something out there that's going to bring all that back in one product. What is this product? Because I need it right now.
That's right. It's called Uber Recover. Uber Recover is a product to be used on your plants after excessive PGR treatment or stress. Check it out at ubergrower.com or ask for it at your local hydro shop.
Oh, I will.
Get to punishing it with Uber Grower and Uber Recover.
Whoa, did we make any sense? Fuck, I don't even know. Did that make sense? Shit.
Coming to grips with measuring pH is a fundamental part of ensuring a successful crop. Of course, having the right nutrient mix is important, but without a slightly acidic pH level, plants won't receive optimal benefits from the nutrients supplied. Blue Lab has a range of pH measurement tools available to help both the commercial and small-scale growers. These include the Blue Lab Guardian Monitor, the Blue Lab Combo Meter, the Blue Lab pH Meter, the Blue Lab pH Pen, and the Blue Lab Soil pH Meter. For more information, visit us online at getbluelab.com.
DFCRadio.com.
Went to Carville to get a milkshake. This honey ripped me off all my loot kicks. The car, oh yeah, there's money in my jacket. Somebody broke into my riding coat.
All right, Heavy Tees Girl Show. We is be live still. After the grand prize giveaway, make sure you stay tuned because the recap of the entire show comes up right after that with GLTV. And also the segment known as Word on the Street featuring Cali Breeze coming up after that as well. We go all the way till 10, which is only about 10 minutes.
Last week's Word on the Street, that little Wayne shit, that shit's getting crazy now, huh? He's like, take the whole team with him. Like, they're not going to have anybody left.
He's like, you know what? Leave Nicki Minaj. I'm just taking that ass.
And he has a $50 million contract. He's like, I'm suing him for $51
million. Yeah, he's got that lien that he has to get on out. Yeah,
actually, man. They stopped manufacturing liens, so you're going to see a whole lot of DJ screws out there coming down hard without any lien left.
Well, that nigga Gross has the Prodankazine. That's right. All organic one.
That's right.
Don't panic. It's organic. Tell people the question.
No problem there.
The question is, it's a two-part, and I don't think anybody's going to get it, but the regular question is, what was the new product that Blue Lab Cindy debuted on the show tonight from Blue Lab? And the bonus, that's old school for those of you who listen to the show. I used to do the Hordy's bonus. The bonus is, what is the name of the event that I went to in Portland on Sunday night at a strip club that also had singing involved? And it's actually the name, which isn't really a word, but it is when you combine the two. So you have to know what that is. It's on my Facebook page and on my Instagram, a picture of the poster of the actual event. It has a specific name which combines those activities, and that's the bonus question. That is not going to be gotten.
All right, we'll just go up the line. Mike from Portland.
What's
is this
up,
your buddy
Mike?
From Portland that you stayed with?
I did not know. My buddy in Portland's name is Brad, but dude, I loved Brad. Screen Door. I loved Pock Pock. I loved Pizza Shoals. They were great restaurants. Portland is rad. I went to Burnside Skate Park, got to watch dudes gromming it out hard in the bowls there.
Gramming
Portland's
it.
Pretty epic what spot. I wish
gramming
I had more
it.
Time to actually enjoy the food culture of Portland. It was fucking amazeballs. Your weather still sucks and it was foggy as fuck, but I really did enjoy the place.
Well, I'm glad that you had fun here. Our weather always does suck, but there's always 100 things to do in Portland. It's awesome.
Always.
Should have said, thank God you left.
No, we love you here in town.
That's right. Horty's like a Hordy. Celebrity there. Next time I go, they're going to have a parade for me on the Riverwalk.
Oh,
walk.
My God. It's not HGH.
Damn
it's
right.
All these guys.
The town.
Oh,
that's
my
right.
God. It's all these people stroking your ego. You're making his head bigger, Mike.
Yeah, don't do that.
Yeah,
Mike.
Don't do that because I wear
I
a
like
7
him,
and 7 8.
I like that guy. He's smart and he's got a ton of knowledge. So
well,
sorry.
Okay.
He's not that smart.
Yeah. I'm not smart. Just most people are stupid.
He knows how to farm spider mites.
Yeah, you'll hang out with him and be like, fuck that guy. It'd be like, Horty's a Facebook fucktard of the week.
It's like, this guy's breath stinks.
Yeah, he's going to do a segment on himself next week.
Yeah, smells like cat poop.
Call myself the Facebook fucktard of the week. You got the answer there, Chief?
I don't have the blue lab unless it's a truncheon or whatever they call that.
That's
but
old
the stripperoki.
Well, you got half it.
You got half of it, but I'm not the judge. The main question was, what was the product that Blue Lab did? Yep. So that's really on Heavy T, because this is the Heavy T Grow Show, not the Horty Chris Grow Show.
Oh, man. I wish it was the
Horty
Chris Grow Show.
That'd be
winning.
Well, that just lost you fucking.
You lost. Sorry, buddy. You said the wrong thing.
Why would you say that?
Heavy T's megalomania will not allow him to share that spotlight.
Dude, I'll tell you what. The next guy's just so stoked.
The guy
right
said,
now.
Too bad it's not the Horty Chris Grow Show. Yeah, you win nothing.
The next guy's just dancing.
He's probably going to block you now.
Hold on. Give me that bullshit song.
Yeah, give him that.
That's that bullshit.
Yeah.
That's that bullshit.
Sorry, Mike.
They got me fucked up right now.
Mike, come on, bro. Step your game up.
Yeah.
Come on, dude. That's way weak.
Shit.
You got to come strong.
Tamara?
Yes?
Oh, Tamara. Hi, Tamara.
Hi.
How are you?
Hello?
Hello, we're here.
We're here.
Hi, Tamara.
Oh, tune in, Tamara. Saying, strip karaoke.
Strip karaoke
is wrong. Yes. And you know what's funny, Tamara?
What?
The last caller knew the answer, that the correct answer for that part, but he didn't know the other part, which you know. So if you would have just been listening to the last guy's answer, you would have got the actual correct answer, but you didn't. So you didn't get the bonus, bonus, bonus. But what was the product that Blue Lab debuted on the show tonight?
Oh, I missed that part.
Man, hey, won.
Do you still like the Heavy T Grow Show, or do you want it to become the Horty Chris Grow Show?
Oh, I like the Heavy
T
Grow Show.
That's right.
Good answer, girl.
Too bad you don't get anything either. Too bad for you.
We'll give you
free
air. Oh,
you try better next time.
No soup for you.
No soup.
Brian from Louisville.
Yes, sir.
What's up, Louisville?
What up, Brian? So what was the product that Blue Lab debuted?
It's the Blue Lab pH controller.
Oh,
that is right. That is right. Yes, sir.
Do you have the bonus, bonus, bonus answer?
I was listening to that guy, and I couldn't hear what he said. I didn't tune in until like 20 minutes after the first start of the show. So, no, I don't have the bonus answer.
Well, that's a shame, but you did have the regular answer. And FYI, it was stripperoki.
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 Dude's version.
Well, you did get hooked up. You just won some Uni One from our friends at
Booyah!
Uber. You want to grow that fire? Uber has the gas. Punish it with Uber at ubergrower.com. I'm also going to send you a light bulb of your choice. A metal halide or high pressure sodium? Which one?
I'll take a metal halide, please.
Which wattage?
1,000 watts.
1,000 watt True Blue from our friends at Grow Light, the innovators that brought us the OG hood, now have the True Blue that are specifically made for horticultural use to get the most out of your vegetative garden. Check them out at growlight.com, spelled GROWLITE.com. And you didn't get the super bonus bonus, which means you would have gotten a lot more. But I'm still going to stoke you out by sending you a $300 Blue Lab Combo Meter.
Damn!
A combo meter!
Wow.
The Blue Lab
man.
Combo Meter is state-of-the-art.
I need that so much.
Now you have no fucking excuse to be growing dirt.
Yeah, your crap ain't going to come out Duffy now.
Make sure you check out their pH controller as well. BlueLab.com is where you want to be. Brian, to learn more about all of your pH and PPM controlling and monitoring. So, hey, Brian, thanks for tuning in and getting
Brian.
The question right, dog.
Keep on growing, guys.
Hey,
thank
Brian.
You so much.
Hey, Brian.
Yes, sir.
Every Wednesday night from 6 to 10 Pacific Standard Time, who's hooking you up with the dopest grow knowledge and the freshest grow gear?
Heavy T's Grow Show.
That's what's up, player. Stay tuned for the recap.
Too bad we never record that.
Again, thank you to our guests. Thank you for Bill behind the glass. For the dude at Meza that delivered all the great Mediterranean food. Steve-O and Stan from Uber. Great stuff. Woo! If you missed any part of that interview, go back. It's not to miss. It's science. It's growing. That's what's up. Taking it to a whole nother level.
Nutrients.
Guys, thank you so much. I'm Heavy T. I'll see you next week. We'll be here with Mitch from Sanctuary Soil.
Oh, fuck.
Let's give it to the recap guy.
Peace, everyone.
Peace. Yeah.
What up, what up?
There it is, what it is. Your boy, Caliente Bridge.
It's your boy, S to the T, St. Diesel.
Yeah, and this is the Re-Crap. Yeah. I mean, we are the artists known as Get Loaded TV.
And this is the part of the show where we break down the whole Heavy T Growth show with all the callers that called in.
Bow!
And a quick answer of what their answers were, you know what I mean?
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
That's right.
Hey, man, we start the show off with Don from New York.
Dun, dun, dun.
He wanted to know a low-cost nutrient.
Hey, man, he want to do organics. You don't want to mess with that Mission fertilizer.
Mission.
That's right. It's only going to be about $60 for all three parts, the grow, the bloom, and the boost. If you want to check them out on Instagram at Mission Fertilizer. At Mission Fertilizer. That's it. Hit him up.
Just like that. Just like that. And then Jimmy called.
Jimmy.
He was having some curling going on, huh?
Oh, yeah, man. His leaves were giving a little bottom curl.
Yeah.
He was using Advanced Nutrients, which is a no-no.
No-no.
They're way too expensive. With the 100 parts, you can break the bank when you can use something that's a lot better and a lot cheaper.
A lot cheaper.
Like Horty said, they don't even know nothing about growing, man.
Yeah,
No. So if you're in that cocoa, man, make sure you throw in some of that Rhizoblast. And you're going to want to use some Cocoa Tech A and B from General Hydroponics. It's a new product line. So if you haven't heard of it, check it out at generalhydroponics.com.
GH.
Cocoa Tech A and B. They also have their own cocoa if you want to use that and be in conjunction.
Cocoa.
I'm in love with the cocoa.
Yeah, just like that. And then Kel, man, he wants to know, what's the best meter to use, Saint?
Blue Lab.
Blue Lab. Shout out to Blue Lab.
Sandy. They got the best warranties. You could go and exchange it right then and there at the hydro shop. All the people at the hydro shop that have it are certified. They've been tested. They'll be guaranteed to hook you up. They got the soil meters. They got the pH meters.
Yeah.
They got the trenching PPM meters. Or you can get it all in one with the combo meter. I suggest you go and pick up that combo meter. Or you tune in to Heavy T's Grow Show and win the grand prize. We'll probably hook you up with it.
And get you one of them joints.
That's right.
Then Tom, man, he wanted to increase his yield.
That's right, man. He was using, he wanted to know also what's the best digital ballast. He was using MHs and fluorescents.
Uh-huh.
You want to switch all that to increase your yield. You're going to want to use a high-pressure sodium light with the real red bulb.
The real red.
That's right. Going to get that red spectrum, which is going to bring them flowers out. They're going to be looking gnarly.
Shout out to Grow Light. Aubrey, what up?
Yeah, check it out. GrowLight.com. That's GrowLite.com.
Then Damon, man, he wanted to know, can you use human shit to grow?
Oh, hell no.
No.
Don't do that, man. Keep that in the toilet, down in the sewer.
Yeah, you can't.
You're going to want to use some clean fertilizers, not from a human. And then also, you're going to want to make sure your pH in your water, like I said, with the Blue Lab. And if you're having issues with your pH pen, make sure you clean it with a toothbrush, or you got to switch out your solution. If you open the solution and leave it there, that might be the problem if you're having fluctuation problems.
Come on. Well, that was just inhumane, you feel me?
That's nasty.
Hey, Paul, man, he wanted to, he had a question actually about his PPM.
That's right. He was wondering about the 500 and the 700 scale. The easiest way is to go with the EC reading, which you could get off the Blue Labs, which is always the same.
Always.
Or if not, you could go on the BlueLab.com website where they have a conversion table for you, a conversion chart, where you could figure out what it needs to be. First, you look at the nutrient. You go to their website. You see what scale they're on. Then you go to Blue Lab, and you can have that chart to convert it for you.
And that's at BlueLab.com.
BlueLab.com or GetBlueLab.com, either way.
Hey, Justin was the next caller, and he had a cloning question. What's the best time to transplant?
That's right. He wanted to know when to pull them out. Definitely you want to pull them out when you start seeing the roots, because if you wait till it gets too big and you try to bury it in your whatever you're going into, cocoa or whatever, it's going to be harder. So as soon as you see some roots, go ahead and pull them out.
Just like that, just like that. And then Luigi. He called in, man. He got a curing question.
That's right. He was wondering if his humidity level is right. He went from 33 degree humidity to, I think he was at 60 or something, because he went and got a humidifier.
Reckless.
So basically, in his room, he had a 4x4 tent. You want a 30-pint dehumidifier, not a humidifier.
Come on.
And you want to keep yours at the 50 degrees. That's ideal. But anywhere from 35 to 45 degrees will be cool.
Just like that. Just like that. I'm just saying, though, man. Tim called, and he had a trimming question.
You're going to want to trim about 50% of your leaves. Never more than that. You want to start at the bottom where the ones are showing a little chlorosis. You're going to pull those off first and then go up from there, pulling out leaves, like big giant leaves that are blocking the under leaves like that. The ones that are blocking, you want to trim those.
Got to get those out the way. You dig?
Right.
Hey, man, Guy had a question about grow light bulbs.
Right. He was using an old used high-pressure sodium bulb, which is a no-no.
No-no.
You're basically going to get anywhere from half of your yield that you could get, which is not good. Go ahead and spend that $90 or $100 and get a quality light. The yield is going to pay it off like five times that or even more.
You playing.
Don't even worry about it. Stop playing. Hit up growlite.com.
You like playing.
Like I said, growlite.com. And you're going to want to use that, the real red, and use it with their grow light hood or their karma hood, mm-hmm, or any of their products work great.
Just like that. Just like that. Growlite.com.
Shout out to Aubrey.
Yeah. And then Ray called, man. You know what I'm saying? He wanted to, he actually started his growth.
Yeah, he was wondering why his growth just stopped out of nowhere and just his plant wasn't doing anything. Basically, he was at 4 feet indoor, which is already too high. You want to be at 2 to 2.5 feet, and then you're going to flip him into flower. He was in a 5-gallon plastic bucket. You're going to want to switch that to a smart pot. But since he's already in there, go ahead and switch to a 7-gallon smart pot, transplant that up in there, and you won't get root bound or that chlorosis.
Booyah!
Booyah!
And then, here we go.
And then we had the grand prize question.
Yeah!
What event did Horty attend to when he was in Oregon,
uh-huh,
or Portland?
Actually, that was the extra.
Oh, that was the bonus,
yeah,
bonus.
That was the booyah on it. We actually had to ask you guys, you feel me, what's the brand new product from Blue Lab?
That's right.
What is that, Saint?
Oh, man, that's a new Blue Lab pH doser.
The it's going to
dose your plants with the right nutrients and to keep it in lock with the correct pH and even like, oh, man, you just got to check it out. Go to bluelab.com. Check out their new doser. It's going to save a lot of headaches and guesswork, and it even they even coming out with one that's going to email you that lets you know that your plant's pH is out of whack and that you need to check it out.
Message.
So check that out, bluelab.com. Stripperoki was the answer. Shout out to Horty Chris, Heavy T. Shout out to Uber Nutrients,
yeah,
for coming in the studio, dropping knowledge bombs.
Man, yeah, it was a heavy show, Saint. You feel me? We got it up in there. And before we end the show, I got to definitely give him the word.
It's time now for the word on the streets.
And it's Cali, you know, Breeze. I'm going to just touch on what went down last week. You feel me? Lil Weezy is suing Birdman for $51 million.
Ooh, first I seen, what was it, $5 million, the first number I heard.
Nah, that's not enough.
I was like, what's he gonna
actually
do with that?
You know what, that's just the amount of money that you know, I think that's left in his contract. He just wants out in his contract, and
I think that was left over from an advance he was due from before.
Preach that part right there. And you know, every number you've been really hearing about the situation has been that number, 51 million. You know, Jay-Z buying for 50, signing for 51. I guess that's to get him out of his contract. So
right, he wanted 50 for he was trying to sell to Jay-Z for 50. So he wants 51 for he can throw that extra in his pocket.
It's an extra ticket to you know, Birdman.
Or I think maybe he's trying to buy himself out the contract. Like that, get the 50 from him, throw it right back, and still have $1 million. And he's not signing nobody; he's all on his own now. Maybe that sounds like a good idea.
Just one ticket.
I mean, if he's going for 50 million and he's suing for 51, he could buy himself out the contract, right?
That's true. That is true. I mean, you know, with a ticket, you should be able to do something like that.
And I think that'd be the smartest move, because if you're independent, man, you own in everything, man. And then he has Drake and Nicki Minaj. Oh, he's caking.
You know, I just want to just probably hit this situation in a whole different angle. And I'm going to just say, man, as a hip hop pioneer, someone like Lil Wayne, in this area in his career, you know what I'm saying? It's almost like, you know, Kobe. Kobe's been a Laker, you feel me, all of his career. And, man, you know, he could have left, man, but he was loyal to the soil.
Right.
So, you know, you got to accommodate him for that, man. You got to take care of him. You still got to get, you know, everything just like he was fresh on the scene. And they got to go the extra mile for being loyal, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And I just, you know, it's just a sad situation to see these dudes, something that had such a big impact on all of our lives, that it just ended on a sour note, you dig?
Right, I don't think anybody's seen this coming, especially from Lil Wayne, like you said, because he's been loyal to the soil since day one.
Yeah.
So now something changed. We don't know what it is. I don't know, maybe it's the new Young Thug that's around taking some of the shine, or maybe Baby's focusing too much on the other artists.
I mean, you know what, man?
Is that why his album's getting pushed?
You know, it was like it's like when the Raiders had Marcus Allen and Bo Jackson. Who right. do you throw? Who do you get a ball to?
Right.
You feel me? But you got Marcus. He's still gonna get his yards. And you got the young Bo who gonna definitely get his yards.
Right.
But young Bo is just that new thing. So it's kind of like, I can kind of feel both sides of the story. You know, you definitely want to be a marketing genius, and shout out to Baby for doing that. He's been doing that for years. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But you know, you gotta take care of your youngin.
Right.
No matter what, man. At all costs, that's your MVP, bro.
That's right. Don't be greedy.
Yeah, man. It ain't about money. It's about family. That's what I saw. You know, from the outside looking in, I saw just. It just seemed like it was supposed to be about family, man. And they supposed to, at the end of the day, come to some kind of agreement.
Right.
Don't fall out over money, man.
We'll see. Contracts are contracts, but we'll see if he has enough stuff to tell the judge that he's going to change his mind and stop that contract, man.
And on another note, man, let's just keep it positive. Let's keep whatever that's going to come out of this. Let's make it competitive. And not, you know, let's still make it ugly. Let's just make it competitive. Let's
keep
it
off the streets.
Yeah, let's keep some good music. You know, let's let some good music come out of this. I know a lot of people feel some type of way. And, man, you know, I think it's good to hear a little steam coming from Wayne. So he can, you know, that's what we grew up on, hearing him just gassing. And I guess you can say, you know, at one point in time, maybe he did get a little complacent. And now you can just hear that he ready to go, man, and that's exciting. You know what I'm saying?
For the
new generation and the old, because the old grew up on him, and the new they really want to hear what's the big hype about.
Right.
So let's get it in, man. Hey, it was a great show. Shout out to Uber
Nutrients.
Aloha.
Aloha.
You feel me?
My partners. You know what I mean? Check them out on their website, or you could just hit us up right here on Heavy T's Grow Show. If you want to hear that new Lil Wayne, you can check it out on the internet. It's free download. DatPiff.
Don't let me forget, man. Today is a special day for a few people. Shout out to I'm going to start off saying happy birthday to my nephew, G Will. You feel me? Mac Squad. You know what I'm saying?
G Will.
Yeah, man. Young man, definitely.
Happy birthday, man.
Definitely doing his thing. Real ambitious and, you know, career orientated. He could be doing a million things out here, running the streets, but he doing this stuff.
That's right.
Proud of you, youngin.
Yeah.
And shout out to J. Cole, you feel me? It was his birthday today, and I'm going to end it with the boss, Rick Ross.
Hey, yeah.
Shout out to Rosé, you know what I'm saying? This is his birthday. These are people who definitely affect our lives one way or another. Celebrate, have a good time, man, and keep bringing us good music.
That's right, man. Shout out to YMC. What is it? MMG.
Yeah, MMG.
Maybach Music Group.
Come on,
man.
You
know what I mean? Shout out to Kate Cutter.
Yeah.
Shout out to Young Breed.
Yeah.
You know, upcoming artists from them. They're really getting on right now, doing tracks with Rick Ross, man.
Uh-huh.
You're going to see them. Check out the new song called Rotate It. You're going to want to put that thing in rotation.
Slapper.
Just like that, man.
Hey, man.
Hey, oh, my bad. Shout out to 7E Gully, too. Check him out on Instagram at 7E Gully if you want to keep up with the Maybach Music Group movement.
Hey, Saint. I don't know. I got a text, man. They said they finna resurrect Pac again, man.
Woo! Oh, man. I don't want to speak on that.
Yeah, we're going to leave that alone. But, man, you know what? We had a great show. But other than that,
we out.